We want to select all the expressions that have a value of 24. So when we have a question like this, it's important to clearly understand the directions. We want to select all of the expressions that have a value of 24. So if we find one expression that has a value of 24, we don't stop. We need to check all of these to see if they have a value of 24. And now to simplify these expressions, we'll be following the order of operations, which are outlined here below. For our first expression, the first step is to simplify inside the parentheses, because notice how the first step in the order of operations is to simplify inside the parentheses or grouping symbols. So we first want to simplify this addition inside the parentheses. 2 plus 2 is equal to 4, so this expression simplifies to 4 times 6, which is equal to 24, so we do check this first expression. For the next expression, again, the first step is to simplify inside the parentheses. So we simplify 2 times 6 first. 2 times 6 is equal to 12. So this expression simplifies to 2 plus 12, which equals 14, which is not 24, so we don't check this box. For our next expression, notice how we do not have parentheses. So looking back at the order of operations, we don't have any exponents. So notice how for step 3, we multiply and divide from left to right before we add and subtract from left to right. So the first step in simplifying this expression is to find this product, 6 times 2 is equal to 12. So this simplifies to 12 plus 2, which is equal to 14, not 24, so we do not check this box. For our next expression, we do have parentheses again. So we simplify inside the parentheses first. So we want to find this sum. 2 plus 2 is equal to 4. So this expression simplifies to 6 times 4, which equals 24, which means we are going to check this box. This expression does have a value of 24. The last expression is 4 times 20. Well, 4 times 20 is equal to 80, which is not equal to 24. And therefore we don't check this box. So our final answer is the first expression and this fourth expression are equal to 24. I do want to point out one more thing. As a time saver, if we know very quickly that 4 times 20 is not going to be equal to 24, there's no reason to spend time determining that 4 times 20 is equal to 80. I hope you found this helpful.